Hi, I'm James Brown and welcome to Pattern Designers. In this tutorial, I'm going to run you through the second part of rotating and duplicating in Illustrator. Be sure to stick around to the end and you can get our free textile designer cheat sheet. Here's some other elements you could use to rotate and duplicate. I'm just going to leave these at the top so you can see what they started from. Rotate this one from that corner maybe. Maybe a bit more, six. Copy and then Command D. So you can see what other shapes will do. Like that's quite, it's kind of like a kaleidoscope. So we've got that, which is the square. I'll just group that. And then maybe let's try the circle and duplicate it from this point, but maybe a little bit, do it, I don't know, about 10. Just preview how far it's going to travel. I really like the circles, they just kind of create that symmetry. And a triangle, I'll just group that. Triangle, just rotate it from there. Copy, Command D. Group. Then there's the line, the base, just a baseline. Let's reduce that to 5. Preview how far it travels. Copy. Command D, and you've got your base circular rotate and duplicate line. Then, okay, let's mash this up a little bit, and we will just on this square add an extra point and move it so we've got a different shape, and then rotate. Maybe from this center point, no, from this. Cancel. So rotating the point there. Rotate from the edge. And then 10, copy, duplicate. Right. Well, there we've got our squares with this circle. Let's try moving that point so it's a bit more of a kidney bean shape, and then rotating from the edge about there, and copy, Command D. Which is quite an interesting one, I like that. Center those. And then, with this triangle, let's just try, we'll go to stylize, round corners, and make it a bit rounder so it's like it's a bit more circular. I'm gonna expand the line, and then I'm gonna not do it from the point of the line, but let's do it from about there. So we get, let's see how far it's going to travel. Maybe about 12. Copy. And then Command D. She's also good again. Group. Just align those. And what can we do with this line? Let's do something different with this line. We just copy and paste it. I'm just going to reduce it. I'm going to use the blend tool. So I'm just going to group those, not group, sorry, select both of those, blend, make, and then we're going to click on our blend tool. Smoothing at the moment, let's do specified steps, preview, and reduce the amount of steps to about six. See what it does. Six steps is good. Press OK. I'm gonna just blend expand, and then I'm gonna try two of these. I'm just gonna move these up and move these up as well, so I can fit two in at the same time. And then I've got these they're grouped, so just gonna copy and paste that and put a second one down there and just show you what it looks like from two different ways. So this is from the center point. Command D, and then this is from an endpoint. Alt, copy. You can create some pretty good, interesting patterns from this. It's really good. Okay, that's it. Hope you've enjoyed this little tutorial. So now you know a little bit more about rotating and duplicating in Adobe Illustrator. It's a great technique to create elements for patterns or to generate mandalas really, really quickly. Be sure to download our textile design cheat sheet. The link is in the description. And like this video and subscribe to our channel. See ya! Thank you.